Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in ac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego, advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesu, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende.
Morning, everyone, and welcome. Now, today is a feast day of two apostles, St. Simon and St. Jude. And it's kind of fun. I was talking with Father Lee in the sacristy before Mass. He said, yeah, we got two guys here with, like, identity crises, because it's not Simon Peter. It's not Simon. It's not Simon Peter or one other one. I'm already blanking out. This guy was known as the Zealot. Jude is Thaddeus, and he's not Judas Iscariot, the one who betrays Jesus, either. So you've got two apostles that are kind of, you know, they fly under the radar, but they're apostles. And we could take great comfort in the fact that while they're not really well known, they've got names that are often mistaken for other apostles. They were called by Jesus. Which means that when, on this feast, when we take a break now, we've been in the book of Romans, right, for several weeks. So we're not going to hear from Romans today. We're going to hear from Ephesians and from Luke's gospel. And I want you to pay attention to both that first reading and the gospel. How the church is built up on the living stones of the apostles. And how Jesus calls by name for us to follow. I'll talk about this in the homily today. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, let us call to mind our sin, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, and forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Now, on a feast day like this, we proclaim the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the blessed apostles have brought us to acknowledge your name, graciously grant, through the intercession of Saints Simon and Jude, that the Church may constantly grow by increase of the peoples who believe in you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you are no longer strangers and sojourners, but you are fellow citizens with the holy ones and members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the capstone. Through him, the whole structure is held together and grows into a temple sacred to the Lord. In him, you also are being built together into a dwelling place of God in the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Their message goes out through all the earth. Their message goes out through all the earth. The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims his handiwork. Day pours out the word to day, and night to night imparts knowledge. The message goes out through all the earth. Not a word nor a discourse whose voice is not heard. Through all the earth their voice resounds, and to the ends of the world their message. Their message goes out through all the earth.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus went up to the mountain to pray, and he spent the night in prayer to God. When day came, he called his disciples to himself, and from them he chose 12, whom he named apostles. Simon, whom he named Peter, his brother Andrew, James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, the son of Alphaeus, Simon, who is called a zealot, and Judas, the son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor.
The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's always a powerful thing when we have feast days for the apostles. Specifically chosen, called by name by Jesus, to take his message, to be empowered by him, and they would carry out his ministry,
driving out demons, curing the sick, proclaiming good news. That what Jesus did, and they watched him, he then turns and entrusts them to do the same, and they go out. And their message goes out to all the earth. That psalm response is an echo of what in fact they did. And this image that we have in Ephesians of this temple being built, this building that is constructed for the glory of God, is built of living stones. And we're here because God has called us by name. And our lives are part of this great, great construction of the faith, the church through time and space, giving proclamation, praise, glory, and honor to God. But we are set on this building that is at its foundation, these guys. Jesus called them, they were the beginning. And through every generation, as their message has gone out to all the earth, a new generation takes their place, called by Christ to be part of the church, alive and well through time and space, proclaiming the good news of Jesus. We look to them for our example. And I like today because, you know, St. Simon and Jude, and you got the list here, right? You know, everybody knows Simon Peter, and I'm rather fond of Andrew. But you have amongst these heavy hitters, now you got these two, Simon and Jude. And you're going, well, okay, you kind of got to go down towards the bottom of the list. And we really don't know a lot about them. But we know that Jesus called them. He called them, but there's a certain level of anonymity. We know they proclaimed, we know they did ministry, we know they went out. And I take comfort in the fact that because we don't know a lot about them, perhaps, maybe we can all consider ourselves in their company. 100 years from now, 1,000 years from now, much of history won't know our names, but God will. And God called us by name. You're here in church, if you're here online, if you can hear my voice, God calls us by name because we have work that is uniquely suited to our lives right now. That he calls us into this world, and he has put people around us so that our message about Jesus can go out to the world today, to the people we live with, to the people in our community, to the people in our families, our friendships, our neighbors. And to those chance encounters where maybe we are the helping hand, maybe we are the hopeful voice, maybe we are someone who has a little kindness and mercy in the name of Christ to reach out to someone who could really use it. Their message goes out through us to all the earth. And as we continue to be part of this construction, this beautiful, beautiful church, where God is the one in control and God is the one who sets all the design. Folks, today we have to take to heart that God calls us. And the way that we discern that and the way that we understand that is, are we taking time each day to pray? To say, Lord, lead me. Lord, open my eyes to see. And then, Lord, give me the strength to carry out what I recognize is your work for me today. Someone might say, but Father, I'm not doing anything great. I'm not going out like they did. You don't have to. Jesus doesn't expect us all to do the same thing. But he's got things for all of us that only we can do. On this feast of Simon and Jude, it's important for us to recognize that they set an example that we carry out. That we are called to proclaim the good news of Jesus. To help others in the name of Jesus. To love and forgive and serve in the name of Jesus. So that the message continues to go out. So that there is hope in the world. So that Christ is proclaimed today by what we say and what we do. We have another generation to raise up. We have more people who need to hear the good news of Jesus so they in turn can be part of the church through all of time. May we ask the Lord for the help and strength we need today following their example, to bring the good news into the world, into the place where we find ourselves, right here, right now. Because that's where the Lord is calling us by name, to serve, to follow, and to live. God bless you all. We pray this day for the church, that we will keep an apostolic mission at our heart, that like the apostles, we will fearlessly go out and live our lives for the Lord. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all who are sick, for all the people who've asked for our prayers by name, for all the people that we know and love who could use a little healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
So weather starts to turn cold, we want to pray for those who do not have adequate food, clothing, or shelter, that through our own efforts, we will be able to alleviate their suffering. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for the gift of life. We pray for those whose lives are threatened, whether we're talking about the unborn or the vulnerable, whether we're talking about those who live on the margin, that life from conception to natural death will be upheld, affirmed, and cherished. We pray to the Lord. Pray for all leaders, church and state, government, industry, education, that their actions will be guided by the common good of all to serve all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
The Mass intention today is for Steve Krenchik. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of you at home, for the prayers you offer in the comment line, and for all of us, for the prayers we now offer in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious and loving God, look kindly upon us. Hear the prayers we offer now, spoken and silent. We make them all in the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, we earnestly ask you to bless our diocese
with many priests, brothers, sisters, and deacons who will love you with their whole mind and heart and gladly spend their entire lives serving your church and making you known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children, and choose from our homes those needed for your work. Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us. Pray for our priests, religious, and deacons. Obtain for us many more. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father. As we venerate the perpetual glory of the holy apostles Simon and Jude, O Lord, we ask that you receive our prayers and lead us to worthy celebration of the sacred mysteries. Through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you. lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
And remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress and useless worry, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Having received this sacrament, O Lord, we humbly implore you in the Holy Spirit that what we do to honor the glorious passion of the apostles Simon and Jude may keep us ever in your love. Through Christ our Lord. A couple of announcements. So for those of you out there in church, but also for those of you who are watching at home, the online registration for the virtual form again this year of our Cathedral School dinner auction is now in place. You can go to the Cathedral School website, you can go to the Cathedral Parish website, you can check it out on the bulletin. There's lots of places where you can get your information to register. Love to have people turn out for this. It all supports the school. It's a great night. I'm looking at some of the prizes already, and are they magnificent? So lots of great things out there for people to look at and bid on. I also want to say a word of thanks to all of you who've been praying so faithfully the rosary for vocations in your intentions. We are well over 10,000 rosary prayers that have been said for vocations for the Diocese of Superior during this month of October. I'm ecstatic. I'm ecstatic that people are praying. I'm ecstatic that people are remembering that, you know, we need to have a future generation of priests to serve us. I was down at the seminary, at St. Francis de Sales Seminary in Milwaukee on Sunday night, Monday night, and then left on Tuesday. Father Dave Neuschwander and I were down there together. We got to meet the seminarians, visit with them, take them out for dinner, pray with them. It was a blessed time. Got to talk to several of the members of the staff, several of the priests who are either teachers or serving in formation. And it's exciting to see. The seminary is growing. And we were able to, with four new seminarians for our diocese this year, continue that. We pray that God will only continue to do this good work. And for all of you who are praying, that the Lord will just tap on the shoulder. A new generation of men who will go out and carry that message to all the earth, that God will continue to raise up those ministers for us. Keep our seminarians in your prayers. May the Spirit of the apostles fill their hearts and help us to support them by our prayer, our service, and our action. Please stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Thanks be to God. Have a great day.